Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So as you know, I bought one of the Redsea ReefLED 90 years a few days back on my previous video. Yep, so it was good. So yesterday when I was browsing through the forum, there's this guy who is decomming his tank, so he wanted to sell off everything. So eventually I bought another Redsea. So now I'm running full Redsea Reef LED system. So just a quick review is that recently I just upgraded from this brand. So this is actually a budget light. So it's a by Aquanite Spectra. It's the M029 model. So you can actually go and check it out. So since the upgrade, this light is, for me, is a good light. Because as you can see, the colorations and everything, so it's definitely brighter and it's definitely better than this light. So this light is actually very good for a nano tank, but it's not good enough for a 3 feet tank like this. So actually this light is good in my view. So there's actually a lot of modes for me to choose. So as you know, the tank mount is over here and you can actually shift it up and down. So this is the LED. So it's a single lamp LED. So there's actually a lot of LED, but it's squeezed into a single lamp. So it's not separate. So right now I'm at acclimation mode because I recently bought a few new Zoanthus and also shifted some of my corals around. So running these two systems now, it definitely feels much more solid. So the build itself is a hard plastic, so the quality is definitely there. So the stand is also quite impressive. So overall, I think this is a money well spent. So if you were to top up, a little bit, you can most likely get AI Hydra already. So I'm just gonna give Redsea a try. So for me, it's actually good. The lights are good. So maybe for more experienced reefer that previously used Radeon, they might find this light not really good. So there's actually an app called the Reef Beat by Redsea. It's to control the lights. So this is how my tank looks like with the lights. So I'm actually using 50% right now, because I'm using acclimation mode. So it's running only on 50%. So I'm gonna put on the orange filter. So yeah, so you can see now. So some of the colors definitely pop. So it's definitely better than the old one. The issue with the Redsea lights is that you do not have the option to customize the color. So that's why it's called a reef safe. Lights, because you will never go wrong as the colors are fixed. The only color you are able to adjust is the moonlight, blue light, and the white light. So increasing them will definitely increase the power. So this is quite a powerful light. So all the colors are doing good. So this light is definitely good for me. So I have not used Hydra yet, so I'm not sure if it's able to compare. So now I'm gonna show you the app. Alright guys, so as you can see the app over there, so there's actually a few modes you can select, but definitely you cannot tamper around with the LEDs. So there's acclimation mode, which they will drop the setting. For example, like I set it on normal setting of 80%, so I can actually lower down the intensity to whatever I want for amount of days that I want. So actually there's another setting for my lights. So as for now, I have new corals, so I will be turning on the acclimation mode for 5 days example, and I will turn the intensity to, let's say, 65%. So during the next 5 days, they will be running on 65%. So after the 5 days, the acclimation mode, they will turn it off automatically and resume back to the schedule which I preset previously. So there's also sunset sunrise mode. So there's also manual mode which you can use to take photos or maybe show your friends of your corals. Cause due to the blue lights, so you can actually go to the manual mode, lower the blue lights and increase the white lights so that you can see the tank more clearly. You can also turn off and turn on using your handphone. And also the moonlight mode, is after the lights turn off, they will turn off bit by bit. For example, from 80%, by 1 hour, they will drop to 0%. So every 10 minutes, so every minute they will drop maybe 1% to 2% of the light intensity. Okay, so you can also add devices. So yesterday I just added one, so that's why you can see two of the lights. So this is the feature most likely you will get on Hydra and Radeon, but those lights are a bit more pricier, but you can customize the lighting for red color, green color and all those colors. So for this you can only change the setting, but you cannot change the colors, the colors you want. So it's actually stuck at the reef safe specs. So the colors are all just nice. You cannot so-called tense up the color if you want. So that's why they say that it's reef spec and reef safe. So no matter how you do, only the only thing you can affect the coral is a par. It'll never be anything other than par. So yeah, so this light is actually a very simple and basic light. So not much customization you can do with the lighting, and it won't be possible to hurt the coral unless you full blast the devices 200%. So this is just a rough review for the lights. So far the lights, I am happy with the lights. So you guys can give it a try if you have a nano tank or maybe a new tank setup. Okay guys, if you have any questions, please ask me in the comment section. And please remember to subscribe. You can also follow me on Instagram at AsianFishKeeper. Cheers.